So this is Dreamtime. I checked it out for like 30 seconds and went, hey, it works. It says it is a hypertext fiction. I got as far as understanding that you need to click around a lot. It is from 1992. Thank you, Stuart, for making this cool thing. I don't think there's sound, which is unfortunate. I found a stream-friendly playlist that's a bunch of video game music that I want to figure out how to do, but I don't think you can do it using Twitch Studio, so I'd have to switch to OBS, which means figuring out another system. So things are just changing right now. I don't know if this is like loading or if this is just being like, hey, I can do all this crazy kind of flip-flop and flibbertigibbety. All right. So
Amazon.
just said Amazon to me. Great. Kindle, Trans, Plex, Fire, Arc. This is definitely like cool when it comes to this stuff. Like, I love this. I don't really know what I'm supposed to be doing right now feeling.
Radical.
Hypermedia.
It's just kind of letting this do its thing.
Gnarly.
Gnarly is definitely how I feel. All right. Oh, if I click, it flashes, so that's great.
Complex.
You are in your big bed in the big black bedroom. Outside, there are no stars, but the constellations on the ceiling as you are left them: Pisces, Cetus, Aquarius, plus the new and improved ones: Binky, Solo, and Ike. Okay. The stars still shine because you used real radium to paint them, and that means you probably shouldn't sleep here more than once a month. Also means the stars can reach behind your eyelids. You know what that means. It's Friday, the last Friday in the month of Friday, the year of Friday. The stars are moving. The wheel that carries the stars is moving. You are going away. A gentle rain is falling across the window, and the sound of it steepens your slide into sleep. You sling down the slippery slide. It is raining inside the room, too. The rain is generic all over idea land. Rain everywhere. Rain.
Bullshit.
Okay. Wow. complex. Worm. Whoa, worm is new. Flow. Arc. Oh. I mean, give him the choice.
Stop, constant stop.
From Evans at singularityzine.com. There's message idea.
Radical.
Date, and that is the system time, which is 6 hours in the future? People you're looking for have just vanished into the sporting goods department of JCPenney's. Six minor ferrets pursue an elegant palomino through the back corridors of majestic forest oak. The world is receding beneath your bare toes. You are maybe 10, 20 miles up and still climbing. The higher you go, the more it looks like an ordinary afternoon in Hoboken. This was the morning the Indians blew up the Department of the Interior. Sorry for that, this is from 1991.
Reality.
Keep it possible.
Alright, Yog-Sothoth. At miscu.edu. You bite into the pear and it's clear and cold and sublimely wonderfully Swedish. And like that, oh boy. Yes, she says, yes, yes, yes. You try to discipline the octagon so it bores out your cylinder head, leaving you covered top to toe in environmentally safe spread latex. Here in the forest, everyone is safe.
Bullshit.
Kindle.
Amazon. Amazon.
Now.
This fire is ours. The day the house went up, you were like, what, 3, 4? Nothing much of the story, really. The woman who did the cooking, Miss Martinez, she was nice, but an ant stung her bad. She upset a pan of oil on the gas stove. You were in the doorway and you saw the flames leap up and the curtains flash. You were trying to scream. But you were standing on a street corner in a housing development of bright August noon, somewhere outside of Washington or Cleveland or Pittsburgh, somewhere suburb American. Your neighborhood, though you've never been near the place before. And there's a 3-year-old running into the street now. Strange how there's no one else in sight. And though she's no direct relation, the little girl belongs to you. You know this because something about her flung-armed gait and sweaty curls triggers recognition. The child is yours.
Really?
Trans.
I couldn't concentrate.
Aviation leak and crash pornography. When you were in grade school goofing off during social studies, you read undercover of your desk a story called The Kid at the Stick, in which a 10-year-old has to take the controls of granddad's Piper Cub when the old fart has a coronary at 10,000 feet. Kid brings ship in for adequate landing with the assistance of God and his dog, and they give him a medal and tell him about death. You should have paid attention in social studies. Then you might not have read that story. You might not, therefore, be having this particular terror dream tonight. But you never listen, and it could have been worse. The other story you remember from grade school is the strange death of Lewis Slotin. Don't worry, we'll save that one for later. Anyway, Here you are, being hustled by the wailing passenger gate. Passenger 8, during the maw of the hurling beast. You are utterly and completely inadequate.
Now.
In a little dark room where the lights flash and the floor misbehaves, you used to be terrified of the things. You used to be terrified of a lot of things. Fear of flying, the least of your worries. Visions of scarified cables, flying counterweights, plummeting cars, shivered timbers, corpses dead by traumatic demonstration of inertia. Why were you so sure the machines would fail you? Can we please, please take the stairs? I don't care if it's 14 flights. Yes, the stairs. But anyway, here you are in the little dark room. Relax, it's only a dream, and you can't dream your own death. Yes, you can. No, you can't. Only one way to find out isn't there. Press the button. Apexville, Pointland, population 00001, all the way up. Whoosh.
Hypermedia.
Man, I just, no lie, love this. This is like, if only we could be making these things. Is it still raining? How could it be raining here inside? Because it's raining inside your head, Doomkoff. How did my spectral emanation come by this German accent? What happened to gravity? Do I still need to breathe? What is a necktie, really? In spite of all these questions, it's still raining inside and outside your head as the song goes. It's been raining for an awfully long time. The world has gotten very wet. The rivers have swollen. The oceans have grown unruly and the seas have encroached. The polar caps have melted. Everything east of the Rockies and west of the Sierras is now property of the catfish, who have escaped from the catfish death camps, declared the sentience, and convened a species crime tribunal in what was formerly a beachfront office building in what was formerly Santa Monica. I'd like to know more about the catfish, but they aren't on the menu, or sorry, the agenda for this dream. Aw. What you see when you see is a rainbow. Yep, no mistaking it. Tenuous and bent, not quite there when you look closely, and yet there all the more when you don't. Have we got RGBiv, all the regulation colors? It appears so. We've always wondered why people make such a fuss about these things. Covenant, Spectrum, Proscenium, Shell of the Cosmic Egg. Yeah, and while you're at it, pull the other one. Except in Seattle, the Emerald City, where you saw one that filled up half the sky, and it was almost surely the true sublime. When you brought this to the attention of a native, he said, "All right, yeah, those." In an age of momentary miracles, there is an unavoidable tendency to inflation. Look very hard at the rainbow, but this one won't go away.
Or...
knit. This might just be time backwards. Flow. New. Arc. Arc. The thing about rainbows, a voice says inside your head, is their tendency to create an anomalous space. Not quite here, not quite. Not quite not here. You're looking very hard at the rainbow. Usually when you do that, it'll fade away. You stare very hard without blinking. The colors become less noticeable. They sidle into the other categories of aeriality and skyness. But this time, when you gaze into the rainbow, something goes wrong, and the reality of this space does not diminish. Rather, it grows and substantiates and overwhelms you. You are staring into unspace, which is not a wise thing to do, because lo, the deeper you stare, the more confused you become, the more difficult you find it is to draw essential distinctions. You want to make this curious state of affairs go away, and now indeed you feel that something is starting to fade. Only the rainbow isn't fading. The rainbow persists. What disappears is you. New stuff. We have a spire. Back to the worm. Opt. An arc. I think opt. I think if I run this again, I'll have somebody choose. Yeah, opt. Back to this lady.
Artificial
alternative.
Amazon robot.
See the fire, he says to you, the fire. But to you, it doesn't look like much like fire. No, it's the sun burning. White gold blob of sunset fire glowing at the base of the pale tower. It's a queer sight. Everything out of its element. The sun at the base of the tower. Black clouds rising from the earth. When the fire starts, you are afraid, and he knows you are afraid of the fire. You're 13 and feel weird. Because tomorrow is your first period. But nothing happens, he says. The fire comes, but nothing happens. It's only a test. The ground quavers, and he puts his metal hand on your shoulder. Well, definitely not the skull. It seems dark.
Hello? Excuse me.
From RWR at jfk.harvard.edu. Garter belt. Before you can think you spit, you realize you are weeping, but you can't say why. God says, don't worry. You've always been part of me. Kendall.
Multiple parallel universes.
Okay, we've read this one before. It's the one about raining and being German. I don't think I've actually gone to the Plex any time. Let's do that.
Knowledge probably is not this.
And you are in the bright blue room called J.C. Penney's, which belongs to a major new retail development raised here on the banks of the old Singapore and Ohio Canal by the H.L. Rouse Corporation. Mall builders to the gods. You're in the main amphitheater off Necessity Street. The aisles are jammed with smart young women in pastel lab coats, each bearing a mesh shopping bag swelled with sacred objects. Chalices, crucifers, icons, knockoffs of the holy blender of lords, and the bedspread of Turin. even the most blessed fragment, pale tuberous length, floating in crystal vial and purest distillate sentence, the signifier Manke, which to this place is its name.
Oh!
Oh? So I think flow means go back.
Reality.
Simulation. No different.
From Ann Bruce at vanishingmatrix.cosm. You behold the definitive cosmic mandala and read in it every detail. But as soon as anything registers, you immediately forget, what was it? You fire the arrow and it comes down in a prolonged arc, and where it hits the colorless but normal-seeming ground, explodes into a Georgia O'Keeffe palette, on which you wipe your putty knife and sing. You realize you're weeping, but you can't say why. God is watching.
Started.
Yeah, let's go back to the flex.
Vanished.
This is all flashing way faster than I can even read. Something about I want to screw, but we're all going to die.
Nothing.
Your catastrophe brain starts working. Mindy Lee of Hoboken.
Nothing.
One vehicle may have achieved re-entry.
Gnarly.
Aeon unfolding. Everything is perfectly lucid.
Reality.
All you need to do is push.
Now.
Somebody whistles, but it sounds stupid. Suddenly, Jane Grass, the Velveteen Bellpole, to summon the staff assistant, who arrives on a forklift carrying the exercise equipment. She wants it out, says Jane. Aha, says the staff assistant. They all grab you before you can get away. You struggle best you can, and it takes all 12 of them to strap you into the wheel. But they do it, and suddenly device is in motion. You're being whirled through the mall, past fragrance boutiques and food rental parlors and Dynamax pet shops. And suddenly, the light is changing.
Amazon.
No, they're not talking about Amazon, but it definitely feels like they're talking about Amazon. Light, it's changing green to ambergris. A gray-yellow changing light as you sprawl on the cart here in your paper gown. They wheel you along with your feet in stirrups. Hi-ho, it's great to be silver. You ask one of the Amazons what it means, this changing light. That's the late light, she tells you. It's getting very late. Count backward from 99.95. And a voice cries out over the retail chaos saying, the mall is closing. The mall is closing and will be closed in 10 minutes. But you've found your purchase yet, have you?
Hello?
Hello. I want to purchase worm. Can I purchase worm? I can purchase moo. I'm gonna purchase new. That was an Ivy College student once.
Busy, busy.
Bullshit.
From Anne Bruce in Vanishing Matrix. Visions of Cody the Bank Examiner. Amazing fireworks in colors no one's ever seen before, blooming gently, soundlessly, just outside your window. Sherlock Holmes is downstairs dictating a treatise on sexual anomalies, so you call the sanitary authorities to change the bulb. It occurs to you that this dream is going badly, so you wake yourself up, figure out how to revise it, then send yourself back to sleep. Except you weren't awake, really. I don't want the place.
Reality
simply
vanished.
This fire is ours. Oh. We read this one before.
Reality.
So what am I supposed to get out of it? Emit. Alright, we're back to this guy.
Echoing parallel divergence.
Now the book is open, you decide to switch it on. Its wheels and pulleys go round and round with all the appearance of high seriousness. Its little magnetos shake and shimmy. Don't touch that dial, the book advises. You touch that dial and 14 little plastic penguins run down the curved linear slope, like little plastic penguins on a curved linear slope. Somewhere in a room far away, in the dark, a telegraph line crackles to life. Food riots have broken out at the Watergate. A white tornado appears like the genius of the lamp, and you have a feeling it doesn't eat anyone well. The little bat-winged fellow with the pointed teeth tugs at the hem of your Macintosh and says, why don't you answer your page? You realize that the book has been speaking to you. It's the end of the world as we know it, says the book. Maintain a certain skepticism, but this time it happens to be true.
Hello?
Oh, well. It's fire. In a little dark room where the lights flash and the floor misbehaves, you used to be terrified of these things. You used to be terrified of a lot of things. Oh, we've talked this one too. Alright, let's see what pops up.
Really?
What am I trying to accomplish here? Is this just like random words? I don't even know what I'm trying to accomplish. Mission Control to Major Meat. We have liftoff. Roger, Houston. Commencing Technicolor yawn on my mark. Yeah! The dark room buffets violently side to side. It's the point the engineer is called Max Q. Eric Severed says in its coroner's voice. And the acceleration continues until your feet actually start to float free of the floor, at which point your stomach becomes a sentient creature, and then, oh no, oh yes, oh no, it's slowing down rapidly, but you're not.
Nothing.
barn door open fast to world. Out you hurtle, thrown miraculously, not up through the ceiling, but somehow out through the aperture parabolically. High height, you rise over the tower itself that stands serene and silent. Miles above the loftiest cloud, soaring gradually slower till you deplete your momentum and hang wide shot, mid-air, independable. Then what? Stylized paddle wheeling of blurred feet, a la W.E. Coyote, followed by departure of A, your gut, and B, your discomposed head. Not at all. Thank you, Mr. Jones, but we can handle this dream. During your best graph zeppelin, you spiral gently down toward the tower top, considerably lighter than air when occasion demands. You close in on the landing field and tiny stevedores tug you in by your boot laces.
Concentrate. Stop.
From Golem at golemwiener.golem.com. One cannot overstress the importance of well-baffled jets. Billions of busy monkeys are swinging through the trees, rented for the return of Tarzan, even though the last thing you remember seeing while you were still nominally awake was Orson Welles wearing a suit covered with egg poachers. The jury believes your defense and condemns you to limbo. The application, Matrix, has just quit unexpectedly.
Eh?
I am wondering if there is a definitive end to this or not. This fire is ours. Oh, we're back to this.
Fire.
So I'm also looking up what the heck this is. I'm looping around to other things. So I'm right now on virginia.edu. Dreamtime is a component of chaos, a work in progress by hypertext author Stuart Moulthrop. The work represents the dream activity of two persons, Aloysius McIntosh and Moira de Cezanne, as well as a third unspecified consciousness. Work is written in Hypercard and employs unique structural devices. On the initial screen, one has the choice of clicking on one of five squares, titled Spire, Kindle, Arc, Trans, and Flex. This gains access to the stack and a collection of sound bites. Hello, Hypertext, Reality, Amazon, Really Complex Text. Within the stack, each card contains a short passage and four transitional symbols, icons that appear on the corners of the card. So it flashes, and then there's the corner of the card. So there's three options. Cursor is always in motion, circling the text, running around the border of the card. One of several links will be traversed. Selection depends on which icon is currently highlighted. The emphasis is on flow, process, and mutation. By always choosing the same icon, the reader can attempt to restrict the path they follow through the hyperbook. This will ultimately be unsuccessful as paths cross and combine. Two icons often lead the same destination. Some nodes may be read only if one particular path is followed. In any case, the chaotic nature of the text itself ridicules any attempt to read linear storylines. Passages are often self-reflexive, containing comments such as, this is clearly often new. So this isn't entirely true because there's, I have Worm. So I will click on Worm when I can. But there's Opt as well. It's showing right now. But, oh yeah, Worm. Animated icon, flashing screens, and audio punctuation.
Excuse me, this.
Really?
Revolution.
Nah.
Complex.
Busy.
Stop. Concentrate.
More text from Golem. One cannot overstress the importance of well-baffled jets. Billions of busy monkeys are swinging through the trees, rented for the return of Tarzan. Oh no. It's the same thing. Passages are often self-reflexive, containing comments such as, this is clearly nothing new. Some are structured to mimic forms such as email messages with addresses such as Berenstein@eastgate.com and themarshall@media.utoronto.ca. Early node contains a sentence, you are in a maze of pointless little passages. A parody of adventure, Dreamtime is thick with such illusions. The animated icons, flashing screens, audio punctuation reinforce the dynamic, playful nature of the text itself. Though ultimately flip and somewhat unsubstantial, Dreamtime points the way towards a more substantial multimedia hypertext than has so far been created. Acts as a remedy for the dry and self-conscious writings which make up many hypertext articles and unfortunately hypertext fictions. So that was a review. Here's by Christopher Lee Keep, Tim McLaughlin, and Robin Palmer from sometime between 1993 and 2000. From the Electronic Labyrinth. Originally written in 93 and adapted for the web in 95. And it's just kind of been moved around. So this is like at the time. This is fascinating. So, okay, I'm gonna call it. I'm gonna say that there's no beginning, middle, or end of this. So I kind of love this. Well, now I can't go any further. So I'm gonna say I can't go any further. I've found an end. The application matrix has just quit unexpectedly.